Hi, welcome to chapter 4. In this chapter, we'll dive into using an image picker. You'll learn how to install Expo Image Picker, select an image from the device media library, update our button component, and handle deselected images. So let's get started. Okay, so here we are in our app, and the first thing that I want to do is install Expo Image. So let's go ahead and stop the server by pressing Ctrl C. And then I'll run this command npx expo install expo image picker. You can learn more about this library in the documentation. So let's go ahead and hit enter. And the library is installed. So let's start the server again by running npx expo start. Here in my home screen, the first thing that I'll do is import all as image picker from the expo image picker module. This way to import will allow us to access methods. Like for example, if I use this module image picker and then press the dot, you can see some of the types and functions and methods that we can use with this library. That being said, let's go down here. Inside my component, I will create a function. Notice that this is an asynchronous function. And using our library image picker, I will pick the image using the image picker.launch image library async. So this is a method that comes with the image picker, and you can learn more about it just by hovering over this method. And this will display the system UI for choosing an image or video. Okay. So this is an asynchronous function. That means that we need to wait for the result. This can take some time. So by using the await keyword, we will be waiting for the result. Now, in order to use this await keyword, we need to mark this function as an async function. That's why we have this async in here. We can also pass some properties like the allows editing equal to true. We want the user to be able to edit, and then we also have the quality. You can play around with these values. For example, if you want a very low quality, you can use like .warm. But in this case, I want a high quality. Now, once we have this result inside this function, I will add if the result wasn't canceled, then I want to put in the console the result. Otherwise, we will show an alert telling the user that you did not select any image. Okay, this is all we need for our function. Now I'll just go ahead and minimize this. And we need to be able to call this function whenever we press our button. So for example, the choose a photo should be able to trigger this action. Let's go back to the button component. And we need to tell this button component that we want to have a handle when the user presses this button. So let's go ahead and add a property called onPress. And the type is going to be a function that returns void. Now let's go inside this button component and abstract this onPress from the properties that we are getting in the button. And now in the pressable, we added this action hard-coded that is always showing this alert. So instead of doing this, I'll just call my onPress function that we are passing as property. Don't forget to add the same for the other case because this is in the if statement, right? Otherwise, we want to do the same, but for the other button style. Okay, and this is how it looks. So let's save this and let's go back to the index screen. And now this component can handle onPress events. Let's go ahead and add it here. I'll create a new line and say onPress and then call my function pick image async. Okay, so I'll open my terminal by pressing Command J, and now I can press the choose photo on my device. Let's go ahead and choose this photo. And now, as you can see here on the console, we get the results of this image. We get useful information like the asset ID. Then we also have like the file size as well as the URI. The URI is the path where this file is located in my device. We can use this URI to display the image on the screen. Okay, so let's try to grab this URI and save it in a variable. Let's create a new variable called selected image, which is going to hold this result using a hook called useState. useState is a hook from React. Let me import it from React that allows us to have a variable, right? So in this case, we will be having the variable here, and we can use this method setSelectedImage to set the value of this variable. We are also typing this. This is going to be a string, or it can be undefined, right? If the user does not select anything, and by default is going to be undefined, this is the value that we are passing in here. Cool. So now let's use this setter function to set the value of this selected image when we get the result down here. So I'll say set selected image, and then I'll access the result. Then if you remember, we have these assets, you can see it in the console, and this is an array, and the result of my image is going to be in this array at position 0. So we can position ourselves at position 0 and then access the URI. Okay, so now instead of having this placeholder image, I can use my variable selected image. But if I just naively put this selected image in here, you can see that TypeScript is going to start yelling at me because this could be undefined, right? And if this variable is undefined, then we will get an error because we will be trying to display an undefined image. So what we can do here is validate if we don't have any selected images, then use a placeholder image. We are not able to see anything because I added this logic after I selected my image. So let's go ahead and select the image again. Okay, so here I have my picture again. And by the way, you notice that I can modify this a bit. So let's go ahead and try to center Canelo there. Let's choose this one. And once I select choose, now I'm replacing this placeholder because now this is not undefined and we are able to see the image on screen. That's really cool. Now let's see how this will work on web as well as on Android. I'll press A to open my Android emulator. Now keep in mind that you have to have Android Studio installed in order to have the Android emulator. But if you want, you can test it out on a real device by scanning the QR code using an Android device. So I'll just press A because I already have Android Studio installed and I already have my emulator set up. This will open my device Pixel 8. Okay, and the app is running. Let's go check it out. Here I have the web app and the Android app. So let's go ahead and choose a photo on my Android. And as you can see, I don't have anything. So I just go ahead and close that. And we get the alert, right? Which is expected. You did not select any image. Okay, that works. Now let's do the same on web. I'll choose a photo and then I'll select this cat. And it works as expected. So this is working with the same code on three platforms. Great job making it through chapter 4. Now you know how to use Expo Image Picker, select images from the device media library, and handle selected images. I hope you liked this chapter, and I'll see you in the next one.